welcome to my fifth video in this series about enzymes, and today we're going to be looking at some more exam questions. So the first question, part C. So the component of snake venom that affects blood clotting is an enzyme. Describe the structure of an enzyme. And so rather than asking about the primary or the secondary structure, it's asking about the structure specifically of an enzyme. So we're going to have to reference things that are specific to enzymes. And so one of the first things that comes up, so referring to an enzyme being a protein. The second thing you have to refer to is 3D or its tertiary structure, or maybe referring to it as being a globular molecule, something of that nature. And then naming the bonds that hold the structure in place that give it the 3D structure, so hydrogen bonds, disulfide. And these disulfide bonds are between the R groups. You then have to talk about, because it's enzyme, specifically the active site, and therefore the specificity of the active site, that a single enzyme binds to a certain substrate that has a complementary shape. 1A here, proteins such as enzymes are important molecules found in all living organisms. Read through the following passage on the primary structure of proteins, then write on the dotted lines the most appropriate word or words to complete the passage. Proteins are made of monomers called, hopefully this should be straightforward, amino acids. These monomers are joined together by peptide bonds formed during condensation reactions as water is produced. Each monomer of a protein consists of a central carbon atom attached to a hydrogen atom, a R group, a amine group, and a carboxyl group. Amine and carboxyl can be reversed there. And this question here, describe the three-dimensional tertiary structure of an enzyme. I've deliberately put this question in, which is very, very similar to this one here, and to see some of the similarities and differences between some of the marks given. So describe the three-dimensional tertiary structure of the enzyme, the fact that it's globular, the fact that it refers to the active site, reference to the specific shape of the active site, again is another mark, reference to the bonds between the R groups, and therefore referring to the correct bonds, so for instance disulfide, hydrogen, that type of thing. Now, if you look at this, there's only one mark that isn't given here that's not the same. So for instance this one here, the 3D tertiary structure, and the reason for that is that's mentioned in the questions. And so you can start to see that there are patterns within the questions. You know what's going to come up, the types of things that you have to say. And in this, you know, in both instances worth three marks. So in this case, if I was employing some exam technique, I'd always say four things that I was absolutely certain on. And so this question follows on from the previous one, and it's asking, explain how the primary structure of an enzyme determines the three-dimensional tertiary structure and its properties. So into two parts. So how it determines the 3D structure and then therefore its properties. So, excuse me. The first thing to establish is what the primary structure is. And so therefore, the primary structure is the order of the amino acids, and that's one mark here. Having the amino acids in a certain order will determine the types of folds and the shape that it will produce, and so that's a subsequent another mark. And therefore, that will determine the shape of the active site. And so what you've gone through there is explaining how it determines the three-dimensional tertiary structure. From there, we can go on more to its properties. So the idea of an enzyme-substrate complex gets a mark here. And some other properties of enzymes. The fact that on the outside of the enzyme you have mostly hydrophilic or water-liking parts, and on the inside you get mostly hydrophobic on the inside, and therefore you can talk about, you can refer to levels of solubility here. The easiest marks possibly though are for 1, 2 and 3 here. If you'd like to join me on the next video, we'll look at one final set of exam questions.